Hey guys, I hope everybody is well. Well, we're in northeast Georgia. We're real close to the Bigfoot Museum. If you haven't went to it, I think it's in Blue Ridge, Georgia. If it's not, I'll correct it. It's the Bigfoot Museum. You need to go see it. But what we're doing today is I'm on some private land that a couple has called me about. Now we're going to be real careful today because the gentleman told me he killed like a 6.5 foot rattlesnake with 18 buttons a couple of weeks ago. And it's been real hot here lately, so we're going to be careful. But as I was saying, this couple has had some activity on this land. The other day he was out here trying to cruise some of this timber to maybe get some of it cleaned up, and he saw a creature that was pretty big. He was pretty sure it was a Bigfoot. So we're gonna come up here and walk up this lane, and you guys are gonna help me look. I got the thermal with me today. I'm gonna take some thermal too, see if we can maybe get it to peek at us. Maybe we can get it on camera. You see all these bends here? They had a lot of snow this year. Lots of snow. And I asked him about these. And he pretty much said, this is from the snow. Now, I do believe him, because snow will push over a lot of trees a lot of times. Now, I do believe in tree structures. I've come out pretty hard against them, but I do believe in them. I want to show you something that is unusual. It snaps like these. Now you see this tree is pretty high, and that snaps at least 7 feet high. Now there's a lot in this area. Now I believe in snaps. These snaps like this, only something very tall can do that. Well, that's what I believe. You know, that's my opinion. So let's get on. So yeah, we're gonna have to be very careful through here. There's some big snakes. And what I'm gonna do is once we get in this clearing, is I'm gonna put the camera down and I'm gonna let you guys look. And I'm gonna scan with a thermal. Just try not to step on no snakes. I'll watch for movement. Let me get my thermal out right quick. Something glowing over on this hill. Actually, I think it's a rock. Pretty sure it is. Right up in that area. This place has a lot of characteristics of some place that has a lot of snakes. So I'm going to be very careful. Let's go forward a little bit. Now this is where I think he saw the creature. He said it was close to a little green field. Now, these things, I believe, can be within 20 or 30 yards of you, and you'll never see them. A lot of daylight sightings happen along roads and at nighttime also. So as you're looking, just remember, we may be looking over one right now. Let's walk up here and try to see what we can see at the top of this hill. You know, we're hunting the creature. And with hunting the creature, it means you may or not find it. Sometimes. But I'm gonna try my darndest to find it. Every time. saw movement up here. Let me get the thermal out. Let me show you something. Move right over there. I think it's, you know, moving that area right there. Alrighty, guys. I'm leaving. My camera just died unexpectedly up there. Tell you the truth, I'm a little shook up. There's been many a times I've been in the woods hunting for Bigfoot, and I've had other strange things happen. This is one of them moments. I'm gonna walk out because I'm kind of a little nervous. You know, maybe one day I'll tell you what happened. It didn't have anything to do with the Bigfoot. It was something else. Tell you the truth, I don't know how to explain it. And we're going to close this one up. I got about a half a mile hike back to the truck. Like I said, I'm in Georgia. I'll be here a couple of nights doing some night investigations with the gentleman. If he lets me, I will release it. If I don't, I will. But we're going to conclude this episode. It's been an unusual one. Y'all watch behind me for a minute. I'm gonna act like I'm not doing anything and see if I get any movement.